Good morning, brothers and sisters. Okay. Saints, no, saints, mga santo at mga banal. These are the people who have lived their lives in holiness and are now enjoying their eternal reward in heaven. And that is being with God forever. No? They are now with God forever. But one important process in the beatification and canonization of a saint is the presence of a miracle. No? Miracle. Isang milagrong nakamit sa pamamagitan at sa tulong nila. Miracle is one way, one of their way of interceding for us who are still journeying here on earth. Nakikiusap, nakikisuyo lang tayo sa kanila, na ipagdasal rin tayo, na ilapit tayo at ang ating pangangailangan sa Diyos. Saints intercede for us because they are now with God. Siyempre, kanino ka pa ba lalapit? Ay siyempre, dun sa mga taong kasama na ng Diyos. In our readings for today, we heard about the importance of intercession. In our first reading, we heard about Samuel's intercession for the people's requests. No, even if no, he knew that their request is wrong. No, kahit na alam niya lang, alam ni Samuel na parang medyo kakaiba yung hiling nito mga taong ito ng isang hari. No, he still brought this request to God. And he then delivers God's response and even message for these people. And in our gospel today, we heard about the act of faith of the four friends of the paralytic man. They brought closer to God their friends, their friend who is in need to be healed. And because of this intercession, an act of faith of these persons, their friend received a miracle. Because of their intercession, their friend received a miracle. Dear friends, saints are not the only one capable of praying to God, praying to God for others, or even bringing the petitions of those people around us, especially those who are in need. Saints are not the only one capable of interceding for other people. Hindi mo kailangan maging santo, yung official na santo ng simbahan, para maipagdasal mo ang ibang tao sa Diyos. Hindi mo kailangan maging santo, no, na kinikilala ng simbahan para mailapit mo ang ibang tao sa Diyos. Hindi mo kailangan mamatay muna para mailapit mo ang tao sa Diyos. If someone is in need of your prayers, take it seriously. Pray for them immediately. Pray for them immediately. Oh, let's be honest. No, let's be honest. There are times when someone is asking for our prayers, we will say to them, I will pray for you. Don't worry, prayers offered for you. I will offer prayers for you. And yet, we do not pray for them. Diba? Pag may na-post sa Facebook, namatayan sila, ano sinasabi natin? Condolences, prayers for him, prayers for her. Pero in reality, we do not pray for them. Pag may taong may sakit, nasasabihin na, sister, brother, pagdasal mo naman ako, please pray for me. Sasabihin natin, uy, pagdadasal kita. Pero pag uwi natin sa bahay, hindi naman talaga natin pinagdasal. Nangangako tayo ng dasal para sa kanila, pero sa totoo lang, hindi naman natin talaga sila pinagdasal. We promise to pray for them, and yet, in reality, we did not pray for them. Well, dear friends, take seriously your call, your mission to be an intercessor. If someone is asking for your prayer, please pray for them. Sabi nga po nung isang pare sa akin, no, kapag may nangingi ng prayer sa iyo, pagdasal mo kaagad, baka makalimutan mo na eh. Pag may lumapit sa iyo, Father, pagdasal mo ako. Pagdasal mo kaagad. Kasi sigurado makakalimutan mo yung pag-akit mo sa taas. Well, dear friends, your love and even concern for them will make your intercession more beautiful. Amen.